What's going on, everybody? Product Probes back at you with another knife review, and today's knife review is brought to you by Kolour.
Yeah, they're gracious enough to send us three knives off of their website. Pretty cool little knives.
Yeah, these are some sick looking knives.
Yeah, so let's go ahead, dive on in, and see what we got.
All right, so we got three really cool knives sitting here. So let's go ahead. Let's jump into it, man.
Let's do it.
This thing is actually massive.
That thing's a beast.
Yeah, and if y'all want to go check out Kolour, I will leave a link in the description below. You know, I was on their website.
They got a really nice website.
Yeah. And it's easy to find what you're looking for. So they've done a good job on their website. However, whenever they sent us this knife, I was excited.
Yeah, I know. I think it's really cool. Probably the best out of the bunch.
Yeah. This is, it's just a larger type cleaver knife.
Yeah.
But it is all aluminum. The whole handle is aluminum, but it's an assisted opening right there. And using those bearings in there that they have actually makes it smooth. You know, it almost feels like a spring assisted.
Yeah.
But it's not. It's just smoother. A standard assist because look at that. However, you see how smooth that is?
Yeah.
And it's able to throw that bigger blade. Let me give you a close-up right here real quick on this blade. So, as you can see, just a nice cleaver blade. Seems to be super sharp. Large bevel right there. You've got the S-Tech logo right there implemented on the blade. Right up here, your jimpings. They've also incorporated some smaller ones into the blade. So, I like that. So, these aren't fit for you. Choke up a little bit and you got a little bit more control of your knife.
Yeah.
That fits in my palm really well.
Really? I wish they would have put the thumb studs at the top just because it is an assisted knife. You know, if you can see.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So, would be cool.
Real quick. So, if something happened, you open it like that, you had the, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Open it up. But, you know, it is nice that you can give it that nice little flick. Super crisp. It has that crisp feeling. It's super smooth. I like it a lot.
Yeah. And I don't know if I mentioned this, but this is by S-Tech. So, this is the S-Tech Cleaver. Now, one thing that I'm glad that they did was make this a frame lock and not a liner lock. Let me show y'all right here. So, you're going to have a lot better locking with your blade. It's going to stay locked better when you use this frame lock. You know, I feel like with a blade this heavy, if they would have done a liner lock, it would have been so much pressure on there.
Mm-hmm.
But they, you know, good job on that. Look how beefy that
is. Yeah, I know. And it's not that hard to open and close either.
Mm-mm. And the handle, I guess this would be
aluminum.
Yeah, this is just a standard aluminum handle, but they cut out, let me show y'all right here. They cut out some holes right here, gives it that nice aesthetic look, but it also cuts down on the weight of the knife tremendously. You know, each little bit of metal you can take out of there is going to dramatically.
Especially on a larger knife like that.
Look at this belt clip right here.
Thing is huge.
It's like almost like a paddle or a spoon.
Yeah.
That you would.
And I like how there's not a big dip in it, so it's not going to fray your pocket that bad.
Yeah. And I'm actually excited whenever we start to look at it in the pocket.
How sharp is it? It seems like a pretty sharp knife. I actually was messing around with it earlier, cut myself with it. I was trying to open it up like this, but it wasn't opened up all the way, and I actually cut myself pretty bad. Wow, you're actually getting some hairs on there?
Yeah. I tell you what, you want to go see how sharp this thing is?
Yeah, let's go grab some paper and see how sharp this thing really is.
All right. Let's check out the sharpness, this big cleaver blade right here. Got Product Pro Ben back there holding some paper. Now, let's do an angle cut first just to test it. A little bit hard to catch, but once you get in there are a lot of rips with that angle cut. Let's try a straight down cut right there. It's a lot better with a straight down, which, you know, with your cleaver, it's more bam of a chop type knife and not so much as slicing. However, you do have a large belly right there. Now, I don't think we need to test the point on it because it's just a cleaver, but let's go ahead and do that anyway. Let's check it out. So, yeah, with something like this, I mean, you do have a sharp point, but there's a lot of push to it. However, if you were to get in there and on the cut down, it didn't seem to be as many rips, but, you know, not a bad blade overall.
So not too bad on the blade right there, man.
Not bad at all. You know, very little tearing on the paper. Did a pretty good job.
Yeah, so far I'm liking this. Again, this is by S-Tech. They'll give y'all another little close-up right here. And this is the 3CR13 stainless steel, which is going to be a little bit better than your standard 440 right there. Black's oxidized blade, aluminum handle. And guys, just a sweet-looking knife.
Oh, yeah.
Definitely quality. You're not going to break it very easily.
We're definitely going to go check out the pocket clip on these knives. But I tell you what, before we do that, let's go ahead and move on to the next one.
So far, so good. Next, we got the, this one's my Master Collection. It's a little dragon knife.
I like
really that. Really cool looking. Go ahead and give you guys a quick little close-up. So as you can see, you've got the Master's coating on the blade. It's a 3CR13 stainless steel blade. You even got that etching on your bevels on each side right there. And right there on each side right there, I guess you can see that a little bit closer. Yeah, as you can see, really nice look to it. It's got the upward TANTO right there, which I like a lot. Gives it almost kind of like a samurai sword kind of feel to it. Now, personally, definitely a lot smaller, but pretty cool. It's got an aluminum handle, but they've kind of got like a little coating, a painted coating on the top. Gives it kind of a rocky feeling. A really cool little dragon. I don't know if you guys can see that up in there in the close-ups, but really nice visual effects to it. Definitely more of a show knife than probably an everyday carry. But I mean, either or, it's super cool. The one thing I didn't notice was it says on the paper that it comes with a pocket clip, and there's not a pocket clip on this knife. We checked a couple of the Apple websites too, and it says it comes with a pocket clip. As you can see, there is no pocket clip on either side. However, it does have that lanyard hole in the back right there. For some reason, you wanted to run a little rope through there, you know, kind of has a little lanyard right there. You could do that as well. Got anything else on it, Matt?
Oh. Yeah, the liner right there, yeah. Maybe.
Little liner lock right there. I like how it has the almost jippings on the liner lock, too, to give you that better surface area right there when you're closing it. The spring assist on it. It is a super fast knife. And it's super, it's really crisp feeling, too. Super smooth. Easy one hand, open and close. Sharpness on it. You know, we did the white one before. It wasn't the sharpest knife, but we'll go ahead, get that sharpness, and see what we're dealing with.
Yeah, and before we do that, man, the looks of the Damascus.
It looks so good.
Hey, I've been a big fan of them here lately.
I wish we could actually get, you know, an actual Damascus steel blade. Yeah. Those things are very expensive.
You know, for it to feel like the rock type handle, it really doesn't have a bad weight.
Oh, yeah, not at all.
But yeah, the, I tell you what, let's go ahead, let's get the sharpness on this thing.
Let's do it. All right, let's go ahead and get the sharpness on this Master Collection's Dragon Knife. Gonna get the paper right here real quick and see what we're going with. So, on the angle, it actually does not bad at all. I like that. There's very minimal ripping on there. Let's go ahead and cut it on the straight down. Yeah, that's actually really sharp. A lot sharper than that white one I tested out a couple weeks ago. Let's go ahead and test out the point on this thing. You know, usually with a TANTO, you're gonna have a real nice sharp point, so... there is a little bit of push right there, but it's not that bad. On the cut down, there is a little bit of ripping on the cut down. Seemed to do better when it's going from the top, so there is... that's kind of weird. Alright, that time it did pretty good. So, you know, overall, it's not a bad blade at all. Alright, actually wasn't too bad at all. You know, I just remember it being not very well, but this one actually did pretty decent on there. There was a little ripping here and there, but not bad at all.
Yeah, and with a show knife like this... I would guess that, you know, you're definitely getting this one for the look because that is a good, and I like the TANTO right there.
Yeah, for sure. I like that a lot.
But yeah, as far as, you know, this one right here that we're fixing to do is a cool looking knife, but I like that one, man. Definitely, I just like the look of the Damascus.
And I like the black a lot more than the white. It actually makes it, gives it a cooler look.
Bam. But yeah, so what we got next in the thing? Right there. Aha. This is a Siesco inspired knife right here. Simple folding knife with a trailing point blade. Let me give you all a close up on this thing. This is a nice looking knife. A really cool. It's got the tiger, like right here. It's the tiger tooth edition, but that gold with those stripes right there makes it stand out. Got a quarter serration, 3/4 straight blade right there. And then right up here at the top, your jimpings right there at the top with your dual thumb studs. And right there, they're not in the handle. They're just incorporated into that blade.
But I like
look at that thumb ramp.
It's super nice. I was feeling it earlier. You get a really nice, good feel to it.
I think out of all, you know, the three that we have, you can get the best control.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
For this one, which makes, you know, more
handle,
sense.
It's right a very there. Ergonomic type handle. Very easy. Feels really good in your hands. It's that G10, right?
Yeah, this is the G10 nylon infused handle. But one cool thing about this handle, let me show you all this, is that right up here, I was looking, and you go, well, what in the world is that? You can take this pocket clip and move it right here.
For the lefties.
And the handle is actually, you know, sweat. Like when you think of like your hand sweating.
Yeah.
You're going to still have a better grip. You know, let's just say you got to flip it open, work on something. It's raining, you're sweating, you're doing whatever. You're still going to be able to have a lot better control with this knife.
And the texture in there, you have it's almost like a sandpapery type of texture with those lines in there. Gives you really, really good grip on there.
Yeah, it does. This knife, man, I'm torn on which one I think looks cool. You know, they're all different.
Yeah,
they all have their different things.
Definitely the best everyday carry out of the bunch.
Yeah, well, and a cool thing about this end right here is you could use it as a glass breaker, but it could also be like a non-lethal type thing. So if you had it in a defensive stance, bam, you know, do what you got to do. You could jab with that. So that's a cool thing about it. However, I mean, flip it on out. It's not assisted. But those thumb studs seem to open it up really smooth. Yeah. Right here in this handle, you got your standard liner lock right there. Seems to be smooth. Your single hand deployment and your single hand close is not too bad.
Yeah, I mean, overall, this thing's probably my favorite ADC out of the group. You know, that big cleaver knife is going to be more for your heavy duty type of work. And that dragon knife right there is definitely going to be your best kind of show knife.
Yeah.
But I like this thing a lot. I definitely like the handle. You know, those G10 Mylon Infused have a really good feel to them. You know, you get those plastic handles sometimes. They feel kind of cheap. This thing, not at all. It feels super nice. And one thing I do really like about it are the finger grooves in here. It gives you a super good grip. Yeah. So, A+ for this knife so far.
Yeah. So, what I tell you what, since we'll just keep the same pattern going, let's go ahead. Let's check out the sharpness on this knife. All right, guys. Let's get the sharpness on this thing right here. So with a trailing point, I know the tip is going to be super sharp, but let's try this cut down. So let's try it right here at an angle. And I like the fact that it caught pretty good, but it was definitely some tearing right there as I finished out. Let's try this straight down. Straight down seems to do a little bit better, but there are a few tears right there in it. But actually sharper than what I thought. Now, let's test out this point. Not much push at all right there, which is, you know, understandable because of that trailing point. The cut down is the way to go. This is the best way to cut. Go ahead and get in with your trailing point. Now, a lot of times, you know, your trailing point is going to be more for stabbing and stuff, but once you get in there, whatever you have to work on is going to be fine. So, trailing point plus right there on that tip. Throw this thing on a stone once or twice. You got yourself a pretty good blade. All right. So, pretty sharp knife right here. That's probably the second sharpest one out of the bunch.
Yeah, for sure.
And I like the fact that they put the trailing point on there because the tip super sharp. You know, you don't see a lot of simple EDCs with the trailing point.
Yeah, usually you don't at all.
But again, it's inspired by Ciesco, so it does have that cool look. I like the gold look to it.
Yeah.
You know? And then this right here, the little cutout here, you could also use to bend wire. No lanyard hole or anything, but if you had to, you could still.
You could, yeah.
Clip it there. But one thing about it is look at that. They tried to, implement that belt clip all the way up, but it does have a deep little thing. Let me show y'all right here. So, I'm worried about this deep indention right here, because it might fray your pocket. However, you see how I'm able to get my finger underneath it? It's not beefy enough to where it's just going to be sitting on your pocket. And you know, you almost have to force it. This one's going to be a little bit looser. Maybe give, what would be the right word? It's not going to, like if I were to hold this down and put something under it, you have more likely of a chance of fraying.
Yeah.
But with it being able to do that, I feel like it's going to have a little bit better movability.
And one yeah, for sure.
Maybe
and
in the pocket?
Definitely. Let me see it. I don't like how far up, as you can see right here. You've got a good half inch right here sticking up. If they could have placed it farther down, maybe to where there's maybe a quarter inch sticking out, that'd be a lot better. But want to go ahead and test out the pocket clips for these all these knives?
I tell you what, since we're talking about the pocket clips, but I agree that it would be hard. Well, it'd be hard to do, you know?
Yeah, especially because you'd have this right here and it wouldn't fit in there right.
Right. But I do think if you're looking at it from a more concealed type look, you might have about a half inch?
About half an inch, yeah.
About a half inch out of your pocket. But who knows? So let's go ahead and let's see what this thing looks like in the pocket. Okay, let's see how this one fits in the pocket right here. So the simple slide in, let's try the single hand. You know, that actually slid in rather nice. That pocket clip does allow it to move a little bit. I was worried that it might fray right there, but I can even, let me show y'all right over here. I can even get my pointer underneath that pocket clip. So that's not too bad at all. You know, a lot of times with the beefier ones, you might have trouble. So let's see the pull out right quick. bam. And there is no trigger, but open it up smooth, single hand close, and then right over here, push down, boom. Now, with it curved back like this, you are gonna have a little bit of that sticking out of the pocket, so I'm not too crazy about that. The print on it does have a good bit of print right there. Now, given again, this is a pair of khakis. However, I can single hand, man, the thing pulls out nice. Slides in, good, pulls out, open it up, do what you gotta do, and you're good to go.
All right, so it wasn't too bad in the pocket.
No.
It actually slid in fine, and that, you know, being loose like that, I'm not too worried about it fraying the pocket. But again, you are gonna have about a half inch sticking out of your pocket. I didn't really like that as much.
I mean, honestly, that's the only bad thing about the knife so far. I mean, the only thing I wish I could have done a little better, maybe I had a spring assist on there, but other than that, you know, it's a pretty nice little knife.
And this smooth folding right there on it.
Yeah.
But I do like that. Now, I don't know, are you gonna wanna check it out in the pocket?
Yeah, might as well check it out, even though it doesn't have a pocket clip. You know, it says it does, but it doesn't. Let's go ahead and see how it feels in there, see how it feels, you know, kind of weight-wise, to see if you can really feel it down in the pockets, how easy it is to take in and out. So let's go ahead and check it out. All right, let's go ahead and slide this down in the pocket. Even though it doesn't have a belt clip, let's do it. Slides in fine. You know, if you have it up like this, it's really not bad right there at all. In and out, no problem whatsoever. Concealability, you know, you're not going to have a problem with that since there's no belt clip. So right there, print, not too bad. It's a pretty slender knife, so you're going to have no problem there. And let's see, just running around. Yeah, it's really not bad. It actually feels super lightweight in the pocket too, so that's actually not bad either. Give you a quick little close-up right over there. As you can see, the printing, not bad at all. You're not going to have to worry about anything sticking out up here because there's no belt clip right there. Pull it out, you're fine. And that's about it, guys. Pretty simple. All right, slides in and out fine, obviously.
Yeah.
Kind of just, you know, walking around and kind of moving a little bit, kind of jumbles around in there. Not too bad at all. Really easy to take in and out, not super beefy. Super lightweight in the pocket, which is nice. When you pull this thing out, it's definitely going to attract some attention.
Yeah, no doubt. And I tell you what, since we're still on the pocket thing, let's go ahead and see what this bad boy looks like in the pocket. Let me give you a close-up again on this pocket clip. So right there, as you can see, it almost, it's like a paddle,
paddle, or
a spoon. But super large, but again, you are going to have a good bit, I feel, sticking out of your pocket because that belt clip right there, it's not all the way up to the top. Now, in this case, they could have raised it a little bit more. Yeah, for
sure. And that's going to be about half an inch, too. Maybe a little less than half an inch.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
So, I tell you what, the weight on it, even to be a 10-inch knife, is still not that bad. So, let's go see what this thing looks like in the pocket. All right. Let's see what this thing looks like in the pocket. It feels super heavy, but let's go ahead and slide this thing down. So, right here. It actually, with the one-hand slide-in, it was not bad at all. Pull it out right there. Your trigger is there. Let me give you a little bit of a close-up over here. So, if I've got it, just push down, bam. And you don't have too, well, yeah, you do. If you look right here, you have about an inch, maybe, of knife sticking out of your pocket. But with that paddle belt clip right here, I don't think it's going to be a problem fraying the pocket. I can still reach my hands in my pocket. Now, given this is a pair of khakis, if you had a pair of jeans, they might be a little tighter. However, I mean, it's just a heavier knife, guys, but it does fit okay in the pocket. Your print right here, you know, is gonna be, you know, so-so. It's actually not as bad as I thought it would, but I guess it's because it's such a flat knife. However, you pull it out, the trigger is right there, and you're good to go.
You know, the only thing about this one is definitely just having that sticking out.
Yeah, it seemed to slide in pretty good.
It was. It's not too bad. You know, for a thick pocket clip like this with that paddle, you know, I don't hate it.
No.
I actually like that aspect of it. Now, another thing that you can do with two of these knives is look at the sheaths on it, because they, boom, they're Velcro, which, you know, if you're really carrying it around, you might want to snap, you know, sheath with it.
Yeah.
But is yours just a simple nylon?
Yeah, simple nylon with the
But look at this on the inside. Let me show you all the sheath. This sheath right here for the Cleaver knife, it does have the waterproof liner or cut-resistant liner inside of it. Now, you see a lot of times with fixed blades, they have that to keep it from cutting the nylon. But it gives this thing a more, like, see how it folds out like that one kind of comes in?
Yeah.
But this one stays high. Yeah.
This one's a lot more simpler, you know, nothing extra special. Just a little Velcro pouch right there to get it in and out. Nylon, super simple. You got your little belt loop right there on the back to slide your belt through. You can't put it on your, you know, slide it in kind of like a belt clip, but you put it around your belt. That one doesn't seem to have it either. Sometimes they have the clips on the back, but
Well, this one does have the belt loop. Yeah. You know, you just slide your belt through it. But see right there, I think this one's going to give it a more, almost like a cell phone holder type feel to it. And that one is definitely going to give you your simple nylon feel, you know, on your hip right there. So do we want to go check that out? Let's go see what these things look like on the hip.
Let's do it.
All right. So got the sheath right here on my belt. We're going to see how this thing looks on the hip. The sheath, you see how it slides up and down like that? I'm not too crazy about that aspect of it. See that? And then watch this. I'm pushing it down. Boop. Like that. But, however, let's see what it looks like with a knife in it. Now, what I did notice, and this is kind of odd right here, is you cannot put the knife in this way. I mean, I guess you technically could, but it's wider right there. And then when you really want to put it in, you're going to run into that problem where it catches on your pocket clip. So the only good way to put this in is the pocket clip towards you, which is what you really don't want. Slide it down like this with the wider part up, and that will close perfect. So realistically, you could slide that thing in there however you wanted, but the best way to do it is to have it like this. So the pocket clip facing down but towards your person instead of like this, or it will catch. So let's show you what it looks like right there. The close down, the concealed side of it. You know, it's just a bigger knife, guys, but look at that. I mean, that's really not terrible even with this short shirt like this. But right there on your hip, it feels good. You know, to be as heavy as I think this knife is gonna be, it doesn't feel that way. You know, I can still move, jump around. Now you can slide this, of course, right here to the front if you needed it, but pull it out. You're gonna have to flip it because of that trigger right there. So I don't like that, but got your Velcro, pull it open right there. You're gonna have to flip your knife to open it. Your trigger's right there. But after that, guys, you're good to go.
All right, we got our CSGO knife right here. And its sheath, you know, it's not too bad. It slides up and down a little bit too easily. Kind of wish it wasn't like that. Not bad, I guess. So, also, pull out. Let's see. Catches a little bit. One thing you don't want to do, I'll show you over here, is slide it in with the pocket clip facing down. And also, you're going to slide in that the skinnier side first. It kind of catches on that pocket clip, so you kind of want to turn it around to where the pocket clip is not facing the front. Slide it down, skinny side down, so you have the kind of the thicker part sticking out the top. Close it down, the Velcro, pretty good. And I guess, yeah, this one's not as bad because on the back, you've got two little pieces keeping it to where the belt's more secure, then there's more room to go up and down, which is not too bad. Concealability, you can kind of see it. It's not too bad. I guess you kind of angled it out like that, but just walking like this, it's really not too bad, but you can definitely tell there is something right there. Open it up, pull it out, flip it around, and you are good to go.
You know, I actually like the feel of that on the hip. You know, when I was putting it in, see how it sits in here like this? That Velcro, as long as you can keep that Velcro strong on it, you're not going to have a problem with this thing.
Yeah, but you know, after a while, you know, if you're going to use it every single day, it's definitely going to wear out eventually.
Yeah.
But you know what? This one didn't feel that bad either. It's actually pretty nice. Not bad at all.
That one you can really get away with the concealed side with the longer shirt.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
This one you're going to have a little bit more trouble, but it is a, you know, when you look at the size difference of them.
That's almost a couple inches bigger.
Yeah, no doubt. Now, I don't know if it was on my hip, but this one felt heavy. You know, it was a lot heavier.
Yeah.
So, what was yours? Was it light?
Not bad at all. You know, that one does have that plastic cutting on there, so it's probably going to add a little bit extra weight. The knife overall is actually pretty nice, too. It's, you know, it's not an aluminum handle, so that G10 is going to make it a lot lighter with the plastic. And this one wasn't that bad either. You know, it's a super slender
knife.
That
one's actually...
felt really lightweight in the
pocket. Yeah, you would think that it was because of that rock feel, but with it being aluminum.
Yeah,
it's probably a good weight to that knife.
It's really slender too, not super fat compared to this one.
I mean, look at that.
The blade on that thing is thick.
Isn't it? It's like...
probably twice as thick as that one.
Boom. That's your size comparison right there.
I mean, look at like the thickness on the top right there.
Oh, no. Let me show you. Thickness of this Cleaver knife. This blade.
It's probably three times yeah, the size of that one.
Three times. And then, you know, that thins out as that trailing point goes. Yeah. But I tell you what, since we're on it, let's go ahead and let's get the weight and measurements of these things.
Let's get it.
All right, guys, we're going to check out the weight and measurements. Got our scale right down here. So, first off, well, I tell you what, we'll stay in order. Let's go ahead, let's do the cleaver and see what we got. Oh, 12 ounces. That is crazy. Let's see. Yeah, 12.24 ounces on this S-Tech. So, pretty heavy little knife right there.
Yeah, let's go ahead and check out this Damascus S right here. Set it down on the scale. 4.44. Wow, I was actually expecting it to be a little bit lighter, actually.
Yeah, it feels a lot lighter than that.
Yeah, let's do that one more time. Let's say 4.48 this time?
Yeah, 4.48.
Dang, all right.
So,
last but not least.
Yeah, let's see what this one is. No way.
5.75?
Yeah, almost 6 ounce knife.
Wow.
So 5.75. That's, you know, that's shocking right there.
Yeah.
I wasn't expecting that. So, I'll tell you what, since we got the camera and everything set up, let's get some measurements on these things.
Let's do it.
All right, let's get the measurements on this thing real quick. Let's measure it like this. So, whoa, am I looking at that right? Yep, 10.25. They were right on with the measurements. That is a large pocket knife right there. The blade on it, not counting your little choil down here, it's going to be four. It's actually going to be a little bit over four. Yeah, a little bit over 4 inches on that. So not quite 4 point. I guess you would just do 4.1 on it right there. And then fully closed, we're going to be looking at 6 inches. So guys, you're going to have a 6-inch pocket knife right there in your pocket. And when you throw that blade up, 10.25 total length on this knife.
All right, let's go ahead and grab this dragon knife right here. We're going to go ahead and get the total length on the thing. Let's go ahead and see what we're dealing with all the way opened up. We're going to be dealing with about 8 1/4. So that's not bad at all, the length of just the blade. We're going to be looking at, looks 3 3/4. And then closed up, we got 4.5 inches. So not too bad at all. I'm gonna get Matt with the last one right here. Go ahead, throw this over here for you.
Appreciate it, appreciate it. All right, let's take a look now at the last but not least CSGO knife. Now this one's gonna be a little bit hard to do. So not quite 9, am I looking at that right? Right at 9. Trying to think of the best way to measure this knife.
Yeah, with kind of one way and the other way.
Yeah.
Looks to be right under that, about 8 3/4.
Yeah, about 8 3/4. So almost a 9-inch knife right there. So, God, for the weight on this thing, you know, this thing's actually a pretty heavy knife. It doesn't feel that way, though. Now, the length of the blade, 3 3/4 inches right there, even counting that little uptick on it. And then closed, we're going to be looking at 5 1/4 inches closed. So, with that little bitty part, I tell you what, since we were saying it, yep, you're going to have about a 1/2 inch right there sticking out of your pocket with a belt clip. But overall, this it is a heavier knife, but it definitely doesn't feel that way. This thing is super heavy.
Yeah.
But it's going to be a given with a larger knife like this. However, you know, with it being in the sheath, I don't think you're going to have any trouble with it.
No.
Like, especially because it's on your belt. Now, it's not over a pound. It's not even really close. But you know what I was shocked about? Was that one.
Yeah, you know, 5.75, I thought it was going to be a lot lighter.
I did too. And it's a 9-inch knife compared to this one.
That was 4.75, I believe.
And then, boom. I mean,
I think we were getting lightweight just because we were comparing them. We were holding this in our hand, and when we went over to that one, like, man, it's really light. But they're definitely about average for the size knives they are.
And you would think with the G10 handle like that, like, I mean, even filling them like, well, this. Well,
look at this right here. You got the you've got this bar of aluminum on the inside, which does going to get
no, that's stainless probably.
Oh, true. You're right.
That's your stainless steel plating.
So yeah, you're gonna have a little bit extra on the inside, and that's pretty thick too.
Yeah.
So I can see, you know, I think we were comparing them to this, the big old S-Tech. When we transitioned over, we were kind of like, man, that thing's super light. But we were just had it in comparison to that S-Tech. But
yeah, so that's the lighter of the knives right here.
Yep.
Next is that one. And then, of course, your big daddy right here. But all these knives are worth checking out.
Oh, yeah, for sure. And we'll leave that link down at the Kolour Codes website if you guys want to go check this
out. Yeah, and even if you don't want to check these knives out, just worth clicking the link and going to their website. They have it set up really nice.
They've got some cool knives on there.
Yeah, they do.
And it's not just the folders. They've got different types. You know, they had to see some from the Game of Thrones. They had the spears. They had all types of nunchucks. They got a bunch of swords, katanas, Walking Dead.
Yeah.
I mean, anything you can really think of is on that Kolour Codes website. Really cool. Go ahead and check it out.
You know what I liked was that Halo
sword
thing that they had on there?
They had the everything on there.
Yeah. So, guys, be sure to go check them out. And thanks again from Kolour Codes for sending us these knives down. That was actually awesome.
Yeah.
But yeah, big shout out to Steve out there. He actually reached out to us and was sending us these down this way. So appreciate it, Steve. And guys, I think, is that it, man? You got anything else?
Yeah, just one big blast thank you to Steve for sending us those knives. Really do appreciate it. Gives us a cool little video to turn out. Hope you like it.
Yeah,
I had a lot of fun doing this one.
Yeah, I actually, and it was such a diverse.
Oh yeah, you know, not just
knives.
You had your EDC.
Yeah.
You had your show knife. You had your big daddy kind of heavy duty knife right there.
Cleaver, trailing point, Tanto blades. Now, it's half serration, all straight here.
Yeah.
So yeah, I mean, just a very diverse group of knives. But that just goes to show that this isn't even scratching the surface with the type of knives that they have.
No.
I don't know, man. I think if I had to pick,
I go with the Cleaver knife, honestly.
I think I'm going to go with the CSGO.
Overall, yeah, but this thing's badass.
That is a badass knife, but I guess if I'm carrying this one.
If you're going to carry, yeah.
When you look at multi types of things I would use it for.
You do have this ratio.
I think
there.
I would do this one. But the Cleaver,
it's a beast
of a
like
knife, yeah.
Getting chicken, just cutting chicken in half.
But I'm also a big fan of the Damascus.
I do like the Damascus a lot.
Like, I like the look. So, if we're going off of looks, no doubt, this is my number one.
Yeah. Everyday carry.
And
that's
then
gonna be a winner.
Yeah, your everyday carry that. And then just your big daddy on the block is going to be that right there. And, guys, since we're actually keeping these knives, we're going to go ahead and make this the Friday Night Knife Giveaway.
Let's do it.
Yeah, let's do that. So, if y'all want to go check that out, we'll leave a link in the description where you can find our Friday night knife giveaways. Another big shout out to Kolour Codes for sending us these knives. And we'll see y'all in the next one.